answer, then you'll get 2 minutes to close. Mr. Whittier. Okay, first of all, I'd like to say thank you exactly like the other campuses there. Introducing myself, my last name is Piers Rosemond-Ronnie, and I'm running for the council at large seat for the city of Valdosta. I am not from Valdosta originally. I'm from Atlanta. I've been here for 11 years, and I can say from the bottom of my heart that since I've been here, I've seen some real changes in Valdosta. When I originally came to Valdosta, I recall seeing streets that were unpaved. I recall streets that didn't have sidewalks. I recall seeing in my neighborhood drugstores, drug dealers on the corner selling overhead drugs. And a lot has changed. For those of you who are from Valdosta, it might be difficult for you to actually see those changes because you've been here all your life. But for somebody who just came, I've seen a tremendous amount of change in Valdosta. I finished Clark College in 1971, Bachelor of Art in Music and Education. I previously worked for the Federal Aviation Administration as an air traffic controller and commercial pilot. After retiring from that job, I went to work for a social service agency, taking young inner city kids, which is an excellent program. We took inner city kids who were having problems in school and so forth, and we taught them aviation skills. We taught them how to fly airplanes. And we kept about 20 kids off the street because we exposed them to something they had never been exposed to. When I initially announced my campaign that I was planning to run, it was in the same room, probably about 5 months ago. And one of the things that I included on my platform that night was I didn't think that the city should include on their job applications a box where a person had to check whether or not they had been convicted of a crime. Since that time, the city has decided to take that box off the applications. I'm not sure if that was a result of my platform announcement, but that box is gone now. So if a person has a conviction, they can still apply for a job with the city. However, the problem that I currently have with that is that they have not told anybody. It's not publicized. So we have people who qualify for these jobs, but they have no idea that that their past history will not be held against them. My time is up.
10 seconds.
10 seconds? Okay, I'll pass it.